Hi masses, this is Saloni, an IELTS trainer and a motivational speaker. Welcome back to my channel at Sacred International. First of all, I would like to tell you that I'm not only an IELTS trainer, even I take the TOEFL classes, the PT classes, the spoken classes and the grammar classes. And if you have any trouble in these classes or these tests, you can contact me. My number is mentioned in the description. So let's begin without any further ado. So initially, I want to tell that this video is for those students who have recently finished or who have finished their graduation or their plus two. Because now obviously they might be planning for their job or like they are planning for some interview. So this video is for them only. Because in this video, I'm going to discuss about top 10 questions which the interviewer will ask you. Obviously, the freshers who don't have any experience how to appear for the interview or how to go or how to encounter the interviewer, this video is gonna be very helpful for all those students. So now, I want to start with this video. So stay tuned to this channel, subscribe this channel if you haven't subscribed, because I'm gonna upload a lot of such videos in the coming days. And don't forget to watch this video till end, because in the end, I'm gonna discuss about the most important question which the interviewer is always going to ask to the candidate. So subscribe this channel and watch till the end. So let's begin. So the first question which the interviewer is always interested to know about, that is, tell something about yourself, which means you need to discuss about yourself, that who you are, where you come from and what qualification you have, from where did you pass, what are your percentages, and so many other questions like this. So in the coming days, I'm gonna make a video regarding this, that how you have to describe yourself step by step when you appear for an interview. For till then, you need to subscribe this channel, because today my motive is only to discuss about top 10 questions which the interviewer is going to ask for you. And even I would like to highlight here that this video is I have prepared this video for some reason, because there was one of my follower on the Instagram who has sent me, who has like requested me to make this video, so therefore I'm making. And if you also have any such question and you want me to prepare the interview regarding that, I am ready to prepare. So do let me know about this in the comment section, or maybe anywhere else wherever you want. So the next question which the interviewer always asks, I must not say next, or the like we can say the another question which the interviewer can ask you is that, tell me about your greatest strength. It means you need to discuss about your greatest strength, which quality you have in you, which you consider is your greatest strength, and you consider that that is your backbone, and you're strongly confident about that quality. So you need to discuss about that. Even there are a few interviewers who always ask the question that, what is your greatest weakness? So with this question, he actually wants to know that what quality do you have in you which you consider is actually stopping you, hindering you to achieve your target. So interviewer is interested to know. So I must say it's a very good tip to you that don't discuss your greatest weakness. There are some students who have a habit of not being disciplined or are not punctual. So I must say don't mention these qualities in front of the interviewer, because that may count as a negative point. And if you still want to mention something, just simply say something else, like you're quite foodie or something else like this, right? Don't give the complete detail and don't be too honest in the interview, because in this way there are some chances that you can't be selected. There are chances that you won't be selected for that interview. The next question is, where were you working? Where were you working means aap kahan kaam kar rahe the? Matlab ki, this is something for all masses, I must say. Those who are preparing for the first time, also those who are preparing for the number of times, or maybe second or third, whatever it is, un logo ke liye bhi hai. Obviously, those who are fresher, unka to kuch bhi nahi hoga ki wo pehle kahan work kar rahe the. But obviously, those who are preparing for the for the number of times, maybe the second or the third times, they can answer this question. But ye question sabko pucha ja sakta hai. So obviously, the examiner, the interviewer will definitely ask you that, where were you working? So you must tell that I was working with so and so company, I was working with ABC company, the CD company. So you need to describe that, what sort of a company it is, like what were you doing there, like as and on what designation you were there, you can say, okay? So the next question which the interviewer can ask you is that is about what was your experience there? That means the interviewer is interested to know that, what is your experience? You can say that I have experience of 1 year, I have experience of 2 years, 3 year and so on according to your profile or according to your whatever experience you have in your life, right? So you need to describe this, and the interviewer is so interested because obviously no one is looking for someone who don't have experience or who lack experience. Obviously, if I am being an interviewer, obviously I conduct the interviews in my academy. So I always look for such trainers, whether it's for TOEFL, for IELTS or PT, who has some experience, who have the knowledge of how to handle the students. Even I sometimes take demo classes from them, right? So obviously, when you appear for the interview, the interviewer is looking for some experienced person. So the next question is, this is a very essential question because this is something I always ask when I conduct the interview. And the next question, in which I believe that the interviewer is most significantly interested, and that is, why do you want to leave that job? Or maybe why you left that job? Obviously, agar aap still abhi bhi us company ke saath kaam kar rahe hain and aap us company ko chhod ke, you wanna move on, you wanna step ahead. So the interviewer is very much interested that why do you want to leave that job? Aap us job ko kyun chhodna chahte hain? And even agar aapne chhod diya hai, wo puchna chahta hai why have you left that job? Ki aapne wo job kyun chhod di? And remember very importantly ki aapke paas is cheez ka jawab zarur hona chahiye ki aap us company ko chhod ke is company ke saath kyun aana chahte hain. And don't say something illogical. Don't say ki mere aisa hai waisa hai. Always have some logic behind that. So the things which you can mention as a logic or as a reason can be promotional factors. Kya promotion chahte hain? You can say that you want high salary package, or you can say that the distance it is at far distance. So have some logical for that answer, right? So don't say something ki kuch bhi. There are some people who appear unke paas irrelevant reason, mere dad nahi chahte main wahan kaam karun ya meri sister nahi chahti. So don't say such things, right? So ye 3 questions to obviously aate hi aate hain, right? So the next question which you get is, what was your salary in your last job? Obviously har ek interviewer ne aapko pay karna hai, so he is interested to know ki aapko pehle kitna milta tha. So you need to define that I was getting 15,000, 16,000, 17, so on accordingly aapko batana hai, or 20-25 jitna bhi aapko package milta tha. And even you can mention the allowances or the perks if you get from that job. So you need to mention, because the interview is obviously going to take the decision accordingly that whom he wants to select or not. So don't forget to have some figure in your mind or tell the truth that depends upon you, that what was your last salary package. So then, why do you want this job? Now the interviewer is so interested to know that ki aap is job ko kyun chahte hain, that what are the reasons behind it. And obviously I must again say, I must repeat that always have some logic for the question. Don't say something illogical. Kuch na kuch aisa rakhe which has some reality in it, right? Usme kuch real ho. So you must say something very essential and important. Just like I already bata chuki hu that you can discuss about the promotional factors, you can discuss about the growth, you can discuss about the salary package. So always have some solid reason for your answer, right? So then is another essential question I must say, that where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Matlab ki aap apne aap ko agle 5 saalon mein kahan dekhte hain? Mujhe lagta hai this is something for which everyone should be clear about the things ki wo apne aap ko kahan dekhte hain in the next 5 years, right? So if you see yourself in the next 5 years that you are settled abroad, or you have got promotion, you have got a good standard of living, you have got a high have been counted in the next higher level of income group. So always have some clear image in front of you that where you see yourself in the next 5 years. And yes, masses, I must want to make the things clear to you that these questions are as essential as the other questions were. Ye nahi hai ki ab hum aapko 5 saalon mein kahan dekhte hain, so examiner is least interested about it. Obviously not. He is as interested as he was in the previous question, because ye bhi us aapko janne ka ek tarika hai. Obviously agar aap bologe ki I see myself working in your company in the next 5 years, this is something very poor, I must say. Bahut hi ek begar answer hai. So don't say this, because interviewer chahta hai ki aapke thoughts ko jaane, whether you are so you can say कॉन्शियस अबाउट योर थिंग्स, आप आगे बढ़ना चाहते हैं, यू आर सो लाइक मोटिवेटेड फॉर द थिंग्स, यू हैव सम ड्रीम्स, यू वांट दिस कंपनी टू बी एट द हायर लेवल, आप इस कंपनी के लिए क्या करना चाहते हैं, सो द इंटरव्यूअर इज सो इंटरेस्टेड टू नो अबाउट इट. इस क्वेश्चन को बिल्कुल भी लाइटली मत लीजिएगा, इन क्वेश्चन को प्रिपेयर करना चाहिए. सो अब बात आती है वो फाइनल क्वेश्चन की जिसके बारे में मैंने आपको बोली स्टार्टिंग में बताया था. देन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस, दिस इज समथिंग जो कि मेरे अकॉर्डिंग एंड इवन अकॉर्डिंग टू द अदर्स लाइक इंटरव्यूअर्स, दिस इज वेरी एसेंशियल क्वेश्चन. सो वो क्वेश्चन है, व्हाट आर योर एक्सपेक्टेशंस. ये क्वेश्चन बहुत 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 एसेंशियल है, बहुत ही ज्यादा एसेंशियल है. यू मस्ट हैव सम फिगर इन योर माइंड कि आपके अकॉर्डिंग दैट व्हाट आर योर सैलरी एक्सपेक्टेशन. ऑब्वियसली इफ आई बीइंग एन इंटरव्यू always look for a candidate who have like who has the experience, who has the qualification, required qualification, and who like whom I can afford, my company can afford. Like he shouldn't be so like ki jisme mujhe bahut zyada cost pade apni company ke liye. Mujhe best chahiye, jisko kehte hain na ki best chahiye, aur wo bhi kam paiso mein, a reasonable salary pe. So everywhere where like in whatever business you are, the interviewers are always saying they have the same thinking, they have the same mentality, kyunki wo company ke upar zyada kharcha nahi dalna chahte. They always have one motive ki wo apne expenses ko kam aur apni income ko higher leke jana chahte hain. So therefore this question main bol rahi hu ki quite essential hai, because you must have some expectations in your mind ki I have this much caliber, mere mein itni qualities hai, itni caliber hai na, I expect ki mujhe itna to zarur milna chahiye. And even I must say ki this question is interlinked with that question, that what were you getting in your last job, ki aap apni last job mein aapko kya mil raha tha. These questions are interconnected. Aisa na ho ki aap bole ki mere ko last salary mein I was getting 15,000 and now I expect to have 10,000. So illogical man, so aisa bilkul mat kariye, right? So always have a figure jo, obviously everyone being a person, being a like a human being, hum chahte ki hame zyada mile, right? So agar aap pehle 15 bol ke aaye hain, and if you think that ki aapko 16 17 20 milna chahiye, you know, I feel like you should be 15 only, right? That is according to you, up to you. So ye ek aisa question hai jiske liye aapko prepare rehna chahiye. वहां जाके ऐसे नहीं करना. देयर आर सम पीपल जो मेरे सामने आते हैं, दे से मैम देखो आप बता दो. नो नो, व्हाई आप बता दो, यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एन इंटरव्यू, घर पे बात नहीं चल रही, आप बता दो. यू मस्ट हैव सम फिगर इन योर माइंड कि आप क्या चाहते हैं और आपको कितना लगता है कि दैट दिस इज समथिंग यू एक्सपेक्ट, कि आपको इतना तो जरूर मिलना चाहिए आपकी क्वालिटीज आपके कैलिबर के अकॉर्डिंग, राइट? सो डोंट हैव अ इनफॉर्मल डिस्कशन विद द इंटरव्यूअर कि आप बता दो, नहीं मैम ऐसा कर लेते हैं, मैम थोड़ा सा बढ़ा दो, इतना सा बढ़ा दो. नो, व्हेन यू प्रिपेयर फॉर द लाइक इंटरव्यूज विद बिग कंपनीज, दिस इज समथिंग वेरी काउंटेड एज वेरी नेगेटिव थिंग, राइट, ऑन योर पार्ट. सो डोंट रिपीट इट. सो यही क्वेश्चन है जो मैं आपको बताना चाहती थी लास्ट पे, कि दैट व्हाट आर योर एक्सपेक्टेशंस, जो कि बहुत एसेंशियल है और हर एक इंटरव्यू में ये पूछा जाता है, राइट? कंडीशन अप्लाई, वो इसलिए क्योंकि कुछ ऐसी गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स होती हैं जहां पे ऑलरेडी सैलरी पैकेज विद इन दिस टू दिस डिफाइंड होता है. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्राइवेट कंपनीज. सो दीज आर द ऑल टॉप 10 क्वेश्चंस जो आपको प्रिपेयर करना चाहिए और प्रिपेयर होना चाहिए बिफोर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द इंटरव्यू. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द वीडियो. पर मैं आपको एक चीज और बताना चाहती हूँ, दैट माई कमिंग वीडियोज आर रिगार्डिंग द इंटरव्यूज एज वेल. सो आप अगर चाहते हैं कि कैसे अपने आप को इंट्रोड्यूस करें, या फिर आपको कौन सी क्वालिटीज यू नीड टू प्रेजेंट इन योर सेल्फ इन योर प्रिंग फॉर द इंटरव्यू, सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल. और उससे भी पहले ये जो बेल आइकन है इसको भी प्रेस कर, राइट? जस्ट हिट और स्मैश द बेल आइकन, राइट? इवन कमेंट सेक्शन में मुझे जरूर बताएं दैट हाउ डिड यू फाइंड दिस वीडियो, आपको ये वीडियो कैसी लगी, डिड यू फाइंड इट इन्फॉर्मेटिव, डिड यू फाइंड इट एंटरटेनिंग, ऑब्वियसली एंटरटेनिंग, बट इट वाज इन्फॉर्मेटिव फॉर दोस हु वांट्स टू पे.